Hello and welcome to Loving Tech Life. In this video, we're going to connect this Xbox controller to this PC. Let's get into it. One thing you'll need to be aware of is that not all of the Xbox One controllers have Bluetooth. Here is an example of a Bluetooth compatible controller. You'll notice that the top of the face of the controller is all one piece. Now, here's an older Xbox One controller that does not have Bluetooth. You can see that the top of the controller looks different, like two separate pieces, and dips down at the front. You can still connect this wirelessly to your PC, but you will need to use the Xbox wireless adapter for Windows. This will allow all Xbox One and Series X or S controllers to connect to your PC. I'll leave a link to one in the description below. With that out of the way, you'll need to head over to your PC to get started. First thing you're going to do is open up the Bluetooth settings on your PC. A quick way to do this is to press the Windows K shortcut, which brings up the wireless display and audio devices side panel. From here, click on Find Other Device Types at the bottom and it'll open up the Bluetooth settings. Alternatively, you can also do this by just typing in Bluetooth in the start menu and clicking Bluetooth and Other Device Settings. From here, it's important to make sure Bluetooth is switched on. If your PC doesn't have Bluetooth, you can add it with a dongle. I'll leave a link to some Bluetooth dongles in the description below. Now that you've confirmed that Bluetooth is switched on, then go ahead and click on Add Bluetooth or Other Device. Next, you'll want to put your Xbox One controller into pairing mode. To do this, you'll need to switch the controller on by holding down the Xbox button until the light is on. Then hold down the pair button on the top of the controller for a few seconds until you see the Xbox button flashing quickly. Now that your controller is ready to pair, you can click on the Bluetooth option and a list of devices will show up. The Xbox One controller will appear as Input or Xbox Wireless Controller. Go ahead and select this and Windows will set up the controller. On the controller itself, you'll notice the lights are no longer flashing and are now just solid. Back on the PC, you'll see notifications that your PC is setting up the device and then that the device is ready. Next, you can head over to Steam and select Big Picture Mode, then go to Settings, Controller Settings, and tick the box for Xbox Configuration Support. You will see it listed as an Xbox One controller under Detected Controllers. You can go ahead and select this and then Preferences. It gives you some additional configuration options. Here, you can rename your controller and adjust rumble preferences. There's even an option to calibrate your controller. Thank you for watching, and if this video helped you out, please go ahead and smash the like button below, and I'll see you in the next one.